Alright folks, so the first booth I'm hitting up today is Catalyst Game Lab.
Okay.
Not familiar with them, they make Shadowrun and Battletech. Okay, quick overview of what we got.
Okay, so Rockmonk disappeared after Fossa bought him. And well, Fossa went under, they couldn't use the name anymore, it was the same.
Some really cool stuff over here.
Okay.
Shadowrun stuff down here. A whole bunch of McElroy stuff in here. They've got some really cool stuff. Interesting book. Battletech, 25 years of art and fiction books. Just give you an idea here real quick. Basically, exactly what it sounds like. It's got a whole bunch of backstory. Very beautifully illustrated book.
With the table? I believe that's a $4,000 table.
Oh yeah,
here, right over there, about 10 feet. All the different Battletech books. A little T-shirt.
You want me to buy you one?
Shadowrun stuff.
No way. He's like a sniper.
I'm ready.
You know
it's a blue guy, green guy, yeah.
Can't hit me. Too quick. Hard over the helm.
This is their new game. I don't get know what it's called.
Yar,
give me an idea.
A mile.
10 and 5. The old 1940 style battleship.
Yar, you missed me by a mile. It's an item like you.
Actually, you missed
that. It's actually really cool.
That's alright. What is all it takes? Miss is still a miss. Only cast some horseshoes and hand grenades.
Alright, you want me to do the big guy?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right, here comes the pain.
Roll out.
Guys, I got another game I got to go to.
So. Okay.
All right. I will take over the monster column. All right, I'm going to shoot the big guy at the middle range.
Let's see if we can find out more.
Leviathan. That's the name. That's their new game. Cool flying in battle. Michael Stackpole.
Yep.
Big fan of yours.
How are you doing?
Pretty good. Big fan of your old Star Wars books, some of your old Mech Warrior stuff.
Oh, cool. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. Really good. Red Sox fan.
Yeah.
Well, there you go.
You're the first person who hasn't given me crap about it today.
Well, it's because I'm not a New York fan.
That's always good.
Yeah, you have to remember the last time the Yankees lost in the World Series was the Arizona Diamondbacks who kicked their butt. So, yes. So we're pleased with that.
So you working on anything new? New books?
Working on, there's going to be a couple of Battletech stories available through Battlecore, so that'll be coming out. And I just, in the 25th anniversary book, I had a short story in that.
Did you?
And then I'm working on a new series of fantasy novels.
Cool.
So that'll be
working on anything with Lauren Coleman?
Well, you're doing the Battletech stuff, talking to Lauren, setting up projects. So I'm really happy that they've got the rights to do the fiction, and as Catalyst's schedule and my schedule sync up, I'm ready to do all the stuff I can.
I saw one of the Battlecore books at Barnes & Noble, and I was really psyched about it.
Yeah, I was like, good,
I'm getting new stuff, and
yep.
I just still haven't gotten around to buying it because I'm broke.
Yeah, well, you know, this happens.
I'm only here because I'm getting paid to be here to work.
And that is how most of us get here.
Exactly. All right, well, it was really nice meeting you.
Very nice meeting you, too.
So,
have a good convention.
I will. I look forward to
the Red Sox.
Yep. We can do no wrong.
Well, there you go.
I look forward to your new stuff.
All right. See you.
So that was pretty badass. He's one of my favorite writers.
Let's see what else we have here. Table card game things. Oh yeah. That's pretty much Catalyst. Right behind him here is Ironwind Metals, who does the metal neckwear stuff. This stuff here I'm not too familiar with. Wolf Star Line.
Well,
it's actually really cool.
Some really nice looking ships down here. Not bad. I mean, gives you an idea of how big this thing. This thing's about the size of my index finger. $12
for a really nice mini.
Kind of look here.
Some of these.
It's a little tough. A little tough to get an idea of details, but really nice little spaceships there. You got some of the big ones here. And these are actually a much darker tone.
I think the lighting
is a little bad for my camera.
This thing is nearly as long as my hand. Give you an idea of just how big it is.
Alright.
Let me see if I can't get one of these nice folks here. I was wondering if one of you nice folks could tell me more about these.
Well, I can't tell you very much about them. I don't really know very much about them.
Ah.
What I understand is that there is a fan site where folks who do original designs,
mm-hmm.
and so we've asked them if we can make some of those designs in metal, and so that's where those are coming from. And these we buy from somebody. I don't know where they come from.
I gotta say, they're really nice. I really dig some of these big ones here. I mean, these are good prices. Oh, that's magnetized.
This is magnetized.
Okay. I was like, they're hefty too. I mean, those are really nice. Good prices.
So we're calling this Wolf Star Shipyard.
Wolf Star Shipyard.
They're kind of generic, generic spaceships. The people who wanted the spaceship games.
So it's just sort of a freeform thing. There's no system to go with it yet.
No. I think people are using, I think there's a full thrust family.
Yeah, full thrust is out there.
I think that's what people are using them for mostly.
Cool.
Or homemade rules.
Well, that's definitely, that's really cool. I'm actually going to have to really look into these now. All right. Thank you very much for your time.
You're welcome. So